Hello there, boys and girls. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to part two of Mending Munich. The first part was out yesterday, so if you didn't see that, we're going to put a little card up on the top right-hand corner and click on that if you missed out the first episode. Just an introduction to the squad and the team. This second episode, a little bit different to my normal second episodes in series. We're going to go through the tactics, play a couple of friendlies, and look at the analysis and just go through my way of thinking when I hit the tactics. When I first start a save, we've got two teams coming up, both which I can't pronounce, so I'm not even going to go there. And all in all, we're going to jump into the tactics now. If you do enjoy this episode, remember, hit that like button, and if you're new around here, hit subscribe as well, so you don't miss out any more videos that are going to be dropping in your sub boxes. So, tactical style, I'm not entirely sure what I want to do with this team. I don't think we're good enough for stuff like control possession, tiki-taka. I don't think that's the way we're going to do it. I'm probably going to end up playing a 4-4-2, because if you look at the team report, I say something I always look at whenever I build a team, the recommended from the assistant manager is a 4-4-2, so we are probably going to be using a 4-4-2 anyway. So let's have a look. So yeah, probably not going to be looking at control game, control possession, tiki-taka, vertical tiki-taka. Wing blade might be one, quality crosses into the box, overloads on the wide areas, so that might be one we look at. Fluid counter-attacks, or even direct counter-attacks, because we're going to have two target men up top. So I'm not entirely sure what we're going to do. We probably will start with wing play, because we can play a 4-4-2. It's a balanced mentality. We're looking slightly direct passing, passing to space, focus on the left and the right. So we're looking at overlaps as well, higher tempo, and we're playing extremely wide. Dispute to flanks and counter, lower line of engagement, and more urgent. So we're probably going to play a wing play for now. We're probably going to go for a 4-4-2, but we will change these. The roles around a little bit. It won't be as seen there. And then what we do is we're going to go into the squad, and I'm probably just going to pick on ability. I want the best team out there as we can get anyway. So we're going to pick the team. I'll show you the team in just 2 seconds. So this is the team based on ability anyway. And we're going to just play around with some of these roles, get them into their best roles that we can. So support target man, and he is another support. So he's better as support target man, and we're going to put him as an attacking target man. So it's a little bit different. Lex can stay as a winger. That's what we want. Keep him on attack. Molly is a ball-winning midfielder, which is good. But I'm going to put Lacazette over there, just because he can play the role a little bit better. I do like a box-to-box midfielder, so we'll probably keep him on a box-to-box and train him up a little bit, just so he gets better in that role. We'll keep Cargo as a winger, and I'm just going to drop these boys back on fullback automatic. I'm not going to want them to go hell for leather up the top. Miles Berger will stay as a central defender. Defend, and so will Weber. So that's how it's going to look in this first tactic. I'm not going to give you full gameplay. I'm just going to give you little things that we can pick up on, and say, just show you exactly what we're looking at when we go through the tactics and what we're picking up on in the games as well. So first game coming up against Mulzvic, and we're going to get into it now. So if we stop this here, this is our defensive shape. We have gone 1-0 up with Mulders scoring the goal, but defensive shape, they've gone for a long ball there. Good four at the back, and we've got Lacazette as that ball-winning midfielder in front of the back four, which is good to see. I'd say wingers and rest of the midfield in a good shape. We've got Mulders just dropping back because he's on that target man support, and then Grimaldi in that target man attack, just keeping the centre backs occupied. But so far, really good shape to the defensive side of things anyway. So attacking wise, this is what it looks like. So four at the back, which is again really good strong line, and then we've got all four of the midfielders pushing forward, and then the two target men up here just occupying the two centre halves. Let's play this on, and we find Lex with a really good goal kick. Mob backing it up with that box-to-box midfielder role, and we go into Grimaldi, but it's a foul given. But lovely to see, good ball into the front line, knock it down, and that box-to-box midfielder in Moll just churning his legs and getting into that final third, which is what we need. Need people to support the two target men. Good defensive header there. And now Mole again, a little bit of time on his hands. He does have Lacazette dropping a little bit deeper, which is what we like to see. And just giving him an option. And then Molders down that right hand channel. He's got two goals today. Molders, Lex into Grimaldi and heads wide. But really good play using those channels to run into and getting some good attack. So it ended with a 3-1 win to 1860 and relatively comfortable, to be fair. Sasha Molders getting two goals there and Cottrell coming off the bench and scoring in the 92nd minute. They got a consolation back with 2 minutes to go, but very, very pleased with the squad and how it worked 100%. So we're going to have a look at the analysis now. So these are the negatives and the positives. So positives, we conceded none of the two shots attempted. So he had two long shots, didn't concede any. Shots from inside the penalty area, scored from 3 of 11 shots attempted inside the penalty area. So crosses are getting in and our boys are getting on there as well. So I had 11 shots inside the penalty area. So the tactic seems to be working. We're having loads of touches in the penalty area. So again, we're getting into the box. We're getting into that final third and producing fantastic balls into the middle. We defended attacks from the left hand side very, very well. 15 of our 84 entries into the entries into the defensive third of the pitch came from there. So we're defending that left hand side really, really well, and we covered the middle pretty well as well, even with just two midfielders. Weaknesses: long range shots. It's a thing on this year's game that you, even though you put no one on long range shots, they still take them. So that's what I'm going to be completely dismissing. We've conceded 1 of 4 shots, so not entirely bad. 25% on target. We allowed the opposition into the attacking third of the pitch to come from central area. So maybe having a need to have a look at some of the roles in the middle of the park and just see if we can make it a little bit easier on ourselves, or possibly drop one of the strikers back as an attacking midfielder just to strengthen that middle of midfield up. And then defensive third, we lost a lot of possession in central areas of our own third of the pitch, so not having too many options when the boys either the back or the middle of midfield have actually got the ball. So something we need to address is definitely that. Losing possession, we only had 43% possession in that last game, so something we definitely need to look at, and possibly looking at some of the roles in the middle of the park. So first thing I'm going to do is pass into space, take that off, because I don't really like that kind of instruction. I'm also going to drop from more direct passing to a standard passing directness. So hopefully we're not just launching it long and going for the big one. We're disputing to flanks, which is good. That's not too bad. And our lines, defensive line, and our line of engagement is pretty decent as well. So the only thing I've done is just drop down the passing directness, and hopefully that will work. And also taken passing to space off, so we're not conceding possession too much. Our next game in a few days' time is Berlin at AK, and again I'll give you little snippets of see how those tactical tweaks have worked in the next game. We're going to keep the lineup exactly the same for this second friendly. See how the boys got. I think this is our strongest team in this 4-4-2. Looking at the squad, I feel that we need another left winger because no one really can play out there. If we look at the team report, other than Carger, no one's really playing that left-hand side role. So we're going to get another one of that position in. Probably look at another central midfielder, possibly another box to box, because a lot of people can play in that ball-winning midfielder role. And then finally, probably a left and a right back, definitely on either side. Again, a little bit more cover in those areas. That's what I'm thinking at the minute. But let's get into this second friendly. As I said, I'll bring you a little bit of tactical stuff from that friendly as well. So about more of the game in this one, more shots, a little bit more possession than we had in the first game, but we are losing 1-0. A good free kick from Milanowski, and it's not the best so far. We're gonna go into the team talk and assertively say, come on lads, show a bit of desire. I need a little bit more in this second half. I'm gonna make a little tactical change. I'm gonna see if we can work the ball into the box, just because we've had 5 long shots within 11 shots overall. So hopefully we'll try and pick a pass rather than going for a long shot. 25 minutes to go. We've made a few changes. We've gone positive as well, and I say, trying to breakthrough. I've had most of the game in this one, but not able to break through the Berliner defence. So we're just going to lower the tempo to slightly higher, and we're going to change from work the ball into the box to hit early crosses, because we are using that wing play system, and hopefully that will help with this final 15 minutes. Yes, 1-1. Lovely finish by Cottrell. 2-2 for the poacher. Putting his name in the hat for a start. So this is the position we got in for our goal. Butcher on that right-hand side. I've switched over to hit early crosses, and he found Ambrosia, and Helmbrecht gets that ball in first time with a great first time cross, and then Cottrell, I'm not even going to start, so I'm going to call him Cottrell, just swings his boot at it and puts it into the back of the net. So we dominated this game. It's just one of those, I think, that we've just a little bit rusty, getting used to the tactic, and as soon as we get used to it, we'll be firing on all cylinders. So we came out with a 1-1 draw. Cottrell with another goal. 2 goals in 2 games for him, coming off the bench. Really good to see a youngster like him coming in and just hitting the ground running, which is great to see. A top goal scorer, we got anybody in there? No, we haven't. Let's look at the tactics. Final analysis of this episode. Let's go to the match and just tick that one off. So Berliner, long range shots again were their weaknesses. We've conceded one shot from that, so it's not too bad. Touches to goal ratio again, disappointingly converted just one of our 55 touches into goal in the opposition's penalty area. So with that one, just we didn't convert, which is probably the story of the game, really, because we had a lot of opportunities, 19, 20 opportunities, but just didn't convert when we're in the middle. Opposition final third entry, so again, essentially, we're getting overrun a little bit, so we need to look at the roles. I did switch up Mole's role to the central defender on automatic, so he'll get up and down when we need to, basically, and hopefully in the next couple of friendlies that will help with the final third entries. And goals from shots in the penalty area, scored just 1 of 14 shots, again, just not as clinical as we were in our first game against Molesvic. Berlin, a little bit more of a more compact side going forward. Positives again, we're doing really well down that left hand side. We even though we're not finishing at the minute, we are getting the ball into the penalty area, which is what we're after, and we're coming, final third entries are coming down the middle as well, so we're looking like that game was probably just a little bit of a blip, and say a few more games with this formation. We are going to make those changes that we made in that game. We're going to hit early crosses, and we're just going to bring the tempo down to standard and just see how that plays out in the next couple of games. But that's it for this episode. We will be back with the first 2 games of the season. Alan and Cockbus are going to be the first 2 games of the season in July. The season starts very, very early in the German third division, but that's when we'll be coming back. But that is it for this episode. If you have enjoyed it, please do drop it a like. Subscribe to the channel if you're new and you don't want to miss out on any more content. And remember, tick that little bell icon so you're notified every time a video goes live. And until next time, we bring you the first 2 games of the league season. See how we get on with those. I'll see you soon.